This is Pastor Richard, and you are watching Anchored in Christ, a vlog from St. Paul's Lutheran Church to know what we believe and why we believe it, to be anchored in Christ's word for us. Now, this week we're looking at that great ascension of Jesus, as well as Revelation chapter 20 and 21, talking about that new heaven and that new earth. But before we really can unpack those scriptures, what we want to understand is this understanding that we are indeed going to be resurrected from our graves, bodily speaking. Now, there's often taught, and correctly, I might add, correctly taught, that when we die, we go to be with Jesus in paradise, which is indeed true. Death itself is the body and soul coming apart in death. To be alive is to have body and soul together. To be dead is to have that soul and that body ripped apart, and that soul going to be with Christ in paradise, as we hear Jesus say to that thief on the cross, "Today you will be with me in paradise," and that body itself being tucked into the grave. That is death, the separation of body and soul. Now, as good as it is for our soul to be with Jesus, which we would indeed say that's a wonderful, comforting thing for us to know that our souls are with Jesus in paradise, it is even better to understand that at that great eschaton, at the very last day, Jesus will come back and these bodies and souls will be reunited for the baptized unto the resurrection and the new heaven, the new earth. There's a passage I'd like to share with you. We'll pull it up here from Paul in 1 Corinthians chapter 15. And the verse I specifically want to share is verse 49. It says this: "Just as we have borne the image of the man of dust, the dusty man, which is Adam, we shall also bear the image of the man of heaven, which is Christ Jesus our Lord." And so this is the great mystery, the great profound power of the resurrection, that one day the trumpet will sound and the dead who are in Christ will be raised from those graves. Think of that great text in the Gospel of John where Jesus cries out to Lazarus, "Lazarus, come out." Those are the words that will come for us. "Matt, Richard, come out," and that body will come out of the grave, be united with that soul unto the great resurrection of the new heaven, the new earth. So as we think about this, the ascension of Jesus, we not only can have this great comfort that Jesus lives bodily speaking at the right hand of the Father in power, but that very Jesus who is resurrected from the dead will come again to claim us, not necessarily just as floaty, ethereal, mystical beings, but taking our soul, uniting that soul with our bodies, giving us a 2.0 body, a renewed body, where there will be a resurrection of our flesh, our body, and our soul coming back together forever and ever to that great new heaven and that new earth. So as we think about teaching this to the kids, we want to definitely affirm that fact that when we die, our souls go to be with Jesus, but that we also want to get that double punch that not only is our soul going to be with Christ, but that Jesus will not forget our bodies in the grave, that he will resurrect those, and not only resurrect those bodies, but give us 2.0 bodies, the same body but better without the effects of sin itself. So there you have it. Great gospel news for us. And we confess it each and every Sunday in the Apostles' Creed, the resurrection of the flesh, the resurrection of the dead unto life everlasting. Because why? Because Jesus is the one who is resurrected. And we too will be like that man of heaven, like Christ Jesus who is ascended to the Father bodily. So too will we resurrect from that dead bodily speaking. Hope that helps, and we'll catch you next time.